Hey guys, today we are doing an unboxing of the Lancaster cast iron number 8 skillet, also made here in the USA. This one I think is from Pennsylvania, from what I recall. Box itself is very light, and the skillet's in there, so I'm guessing it's not very heavy, which is very nice. So here we got, you know, where we can cook, where you can use it, what they recommend, giving you dimensions. 4 pounds is what it weighs, so very lightweight, considering it's cast iron. And let's open this up. And what do we have here? We got a letter. Looks like it's handwritten. Welcome to the family, Lancaster family. Hope you enjoy using your new skillet. Happy cooking, Alyssa. Lancaster cast iron. And then we got some more. We got some information here. First time use, what they recommend. Looks like they're saying gently wash your new Lancaster skillet with soap and water. Dry thoroughly before making your first meal. Otherwise, no preparation is required as your new skillet is pre-seasoned, enabling you to begin cooking right out of the box. Be generous with the amount of cooking oil. Olive oil is our favorite. I don't use olive oil unless it's for... I really don't use olive oil. What I use is either canola or grapeseed oil. Or I use vegetable oil. If I'm gonna deep fry, sometimes I'll use Crisco. But other than that, I rarely use olive oil unless we're doing some kind of pasta dish or something like that. But usually I don't use it on my cast iron. I know a lot of people like using olive oil. I think it's great. I know it does have a taste to it, so that's why I don't use it. But anyway, I mean, yeah, it says here that olive oil is their preference. What else? Let's see. Use until you build up a substantial seasoning. Always allow the skillet to heat up before adding food. You will rarely prepare food in a cold cast iron skillet. Start with meals that include sauteed vegetables, cornbread, or fried eggs. Avoid cooking high acidic foods such as tomatoes or sugary foods such as bacon until you have built up a good amount of seasoning. I agree with that because I've done bacon. A lot of people recommend using bacon, but from what I've heard, bacon has a lot of sugar added to it, unless it's natural. Same thing with lard. I know that they have some kind of additive for the lard. Honestly, it's better if you use lard, you know, like from an actual butcher shop that's fresh. But so bacon would be good, or lard from a butcher shop, but bacon that is fresh, something from the butcher shop. And typically, if you buy from any company that's, you know, like a brand name, a corporation, something big where they sell nationwide, they usually have a lot of additives, a lot of they just put a lot of stuff in it, preservatives and all that, and sugar. So yeah, it's gonna stick to your pan, and I've noticed that actually. The food, you know, bacon sticks loves to stick to a pan, even if you have a really good seasoning on it, it's gonna stick to your pan. But anyway, obviously you got to clean it, wipe it out, clean it up, dry it off, heat it up, and then, you know, evaporate any of the remaining water by heating it on the stove. Wipe with an extremely light coat of oil, let it cool, and store seasoning pretty much. And explaining, you know, what seasoning is. If you know about cast iron, you got to season it. Pretty much a polymerized oil that dried and hardened by heating it on the skillet. So, very nice, very informative. Great that they include this. And with the pan, it's a gray color. I think this is the first time I see one that's gray. You know, like a brand new skillet. I don't think I've, well, some, actually, I've noticed that some lodge, some have this gray color. This one's very gray, almost like steel. Don't know exactly how or what type of metal they use, or iron, but it's very nice. The texture actually is very smooth. It's not as rough like lodge, which is nice. Very smooth, actually. And this one's made, yeah, see, this Lancaster is from Pennsylvania, USA. This is their number 8. Got a small heat ring, which is nice. And it's a very nice skillet. And actually, it's very lightweight, not heavy at all, which is very nice considering its size. And you can see here, it's been machined. You can hear it. It's been machined, but the walls look like they've been sanded, and the bottom is machined because you can see the grooves. But the sidewalls definitely look like they've been, like some, you know, they sanded it down. And you can tell here specifically on the pour spouts. It's not rough, very smooth, and like I said, yeah, it almost looks like somebody took their time to possibly hand. I think that's what they do. Because they're not a big company. I think they hand, you know, hand you everything, all of this, which is very nice. So I'm happy to have, you know, bought this. I'm gonna season it first. Not saying that their seasoning is bad or anything like that, but I do prefer always a coat, at least one or two rounds before I cook. But I'm gonna give it a wash and cook, and I'll let you guys know what I think. But it's a very nice skillet, very lightweight, very surprised actually. And it looks like a vintage pan. Doesn't look like it's a newer pan. It looks something you would see from back then. Very nice. The handle is very thin. Actually, you can see here, very thin handle. And very nice. I mean, there's some flaws to it, but some little I've noticed like pinholes, but nothing that's gonna, you know, be wrong with the structure. Everything is great. I am very impressed, and I'll let you guys know once I, you know, I'll cook some food, and I'll let you guys know what I think. I'll post a video, but pretty much an unboxing. Don't know how many there are out there, but this is Lancaster. And I also have Northern Company, which is based from Utah, I think. And I got that one coming in, so I'll post that one as well. And I hope you guys enjoyed this. My kids are playing around, but hope you guys enjoyed. I appreciate your guys' time. Leave some comments if you guys want to see more or anything. If you guys have any questions, let me know. Give me a thumbs up, a like, and subscribe if you want to see more of this stuff. More cast iron. Cooking cast iron is pretty much what I'm about. But like I said, thank you very much. And, actually, before I, you know, their website, they actually don't just sell skillets. They also sell a lot of wooden utensils. And they sell a handle for this, which I bought one. And I'm going to wait, you know, I'm going to review that as well once I get it in. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll, like I said, I'll be posting more, and I hope you guys tune in for that.